My name is Peter, and I want to be a mighty streamer. Okay, let's jump in, guys. Welcome to one of my favorite games of all time. Oh man, look at this. Ron Gilbert's masterpiece. Hi! My name's Guybrush Threepwood, and I want to be a pirate. Yikes! Don't sneak up on me like that. I'm over this way. Ah! Well then, Thriftweed. Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood. I see. So you want to be a pirate, eh? You look more like a flooring inspector. But if you're serious about pirating, then go talk to the pirate leaders. You'll find them in the scum bar. Gosh, thanks. I'll do that. Bye now. I'm off to seek my fortune. Good luck, scum bar. You just push open. Ah, yes. All my pirates will be talking the same.
Hey there, stranger. New in town.
My name's Guybrush Threepwood. I'm new in town.
Guybrush Threepwood. That's the stupidest name I've ever heard.
I don't know. I kind of like Guybrush.
But it's not even a name.
Well, what's your name?
My name is Mancone Seepgood. So what brings you up to Melee Island anyway?
I forgot that he had the exact same name.
I want to be a pirate.
Oh, really? You should talk to the important looking fellers in the next room. They're pretty much in charge around here. They can tell you where to go and what to do.
Where can I find the governor?
Governor Marley.
I'll move the camera. Hold on a minute.
Her mansion's on the other side of town, but pirates aren't as welcome around her place as they used to be.
Why not?
Well, the last time she had a pirate over for dinner, he fell in love with her. It's made things rather uncomfortable for everybody.
Who is this pirate?
Oh, there's none other than the fearsome pirate, LeChuck. Well, there's a whole big story about what happened next. I wouldn't believe a word of it. Estevan over there at the other table might be able to tell you all about it. He takes the whole thing pretty seriously. Very seriously. Oh, looks like my grog's going flat, so you'll have to excuse me. Nice talking to you.
How could TJ already be asleep?
Have fun on Melee Island, trademarked.
All right, maybe like right here is best in case there's talking in the top left. There's no way we're gonna beat this game tonight with me talking over everybody. Like literally 0% chance. I don't think it's wise to wake a sleeping pirate.
What are you looking at me for?
I'd like to introduce myself. My name's Guybrush. Yeah, so what? Can you tell me the story about this LeChuck guy?
LeChuck?
He's the guy that went around to the governor's for dinner. Never wanted to leave. He fell for her in a big way, but she told him to drop dead. So he did. Then things really got ugly. How did things get ugly? More like LeCuck. LeChuck was a fearsome pirate. He tried to impress the governor by sailing off to find the secret of Mankey Island, but a mysterious storm came up and sank his ship, leaving no survivors. We thought that was the end of the fearsome pirate LeChuck. We were wrong.
What happened then?
He still sails the water between here and Mankey Island. His ghost ship is an unholy terror upon the sea. That's why we're all in here and not out pirating. Excuse me, but I'm looking for the dartboard. Dartboard? We don't have one anymore. There was a terrible accident. Drinking and darts don't mix.
That's actually very true. Ask Zudu and I often go back out to get beers together, and drinking and darts really don't match.
He actually said trademarked. Yeah, it's trademarked. It's Melee Island trademarked. What happened to your eye?
Well, I was putting in my contact lens when... Hey, wait a second. That's none of your goddamn business.
Sorry to bother you. Bye.
Right. Now, let's see how it looks. This is the modern version of the game. So there's two different versions, right? You can go back and forth between the two. Pretty impressive how they... I think this one has way more charm.
I yourself.
So, tell me about Loom.
You mean the latest masterpiece of fantasy storytelling from Lucasfilm's Brian Moriarty?
Why, it's an extraordinary adventure with an interface of magic. Stunning, high resolution, 3D landscapes, sophisticated score and musical effects, not to mention the detailed animation and special effects. Elegant point-and-click control of characters, objects, and magic spells. Beat the rush! Go out and buy Loom today!
Jeez, what an obvious sales pitch.
Sorry, but on some topics I just get carried away.
There's the next game, put Loom on the board! Do the conversations scale up like that?
Can you describe scale up?
Ah, here's the important looking... There's in-game ads. Sorry, I just got paid. This is my sponsor. Hope you guys don't mind.
I want to be a pirate. So what?
Why bother us?
Hey, don't forget we're short on help because of this whole LeChuck thing. So? So, no pirates means no swag, and no swag means no grog, and we're getting dangerously low on grog.
Huh.
Do you have any special skills? I can hold my breath for 10 minutes.
Well, alright, but you just don't become a pirate just by asking. You'll have to go through the 3 trials!
Yeah... What 3 trials are those?
There are 3 trials every pirate must pass. You must master the sword, the art of thievery, and the quest.
The what?
Treasure hunting, you see, Archon?
Right. You must prove yourself in each of these 3 areas. Swordplay, thievery, and treasure huntery. Then return with proof that you've done it.
And then you must drink grog with us. Grog! Grog!
Okay. Alright, these are going to be very inconsistent voices throughout the night. I better keep myself hydrated. Well, which one do you guys want to do first? Sword, thievery, or treasure hunting?
Tell me more about mastering the sword.
First, you get a sword. You must seek out and defeat the sword master. Someone in town can probably direct you.
Ah, the voices are,
you'll want to find someone to train you first.
Imagine trying to take on the sword master without any training.
Okay, there we go. Gotta find that. We gotta find some of those.
You're a bunch of foul-smelling, grog-swilling pigs!
Be a pirate. You must also be a foul-smelling, grog-swilling pig.
That's actually kind of funny. I guess that's part of the requirements. What's in that grog stuff anyway?
Grog is a mixture of one of the more following. Kerosene, propan glycol, artificial sweeteners, sulfuric acid, a rum, acetone, red dye number 2, scum, axle grease, battery acid, and or pepperoni. As you can probably imagine, it's one of the most caustic, volatile substances known to man. The stuff eats right through these mugs, and the cook is losing a fortune replacing them. Har, har, har.
That's pretty interesting. I'll just be running along now.
Leave us to our grog. Come back later and tell us how you're doing.
So what's the overarching story here?
Deep beneath Monkey Island, the ghost pirate LeChuck's ship lies anchored in a river of lava.
Can you guys hear this music?
Captain LeChuck, sir, there's nothing like the hot winds of hell blowing in your face.
No, sir. No, nothing like it.
It's days like this that makes you glad to be dead.
Oh, yes, sir. Glad to be dead.
You are glad to be dead, right?
Oh, yes, sir. I feel so lucky that you happened to capture my ship, then murdered me and everyone on board.
Yes, sir. Lucky. Glad to hear it. Now, what was it you disturbed me for?
Ah, yes, sir. Well, you see, we might have a problem on Melee Island.
Problem? What possible problem could there be? I've got those sissy pirates so scared of the sea they're afraid to take a bath.
Well, there seems to be a new pirate in town. Actually, he's a pirate wannabe. Young, inexperienced, but probably nothing to worry about. Don't know why I bothered you with it. I'll have him taken care of myself.
Wait. I'll handle this. Personally, my plans are too important to be messed up by amateurs.
Yes, sir.
This is back when these adventure games, kind of the allure of them is the story unfolds as you go around talking to random NPCs, non-playable characters, collecting different items. Then you try to figure out, what are these items for? How can I use them? There's really no time limits. Although some characters do have like little routines, like the cook will go in and out and stuff like that. There's only one way you can like die in the game.
Excuse me. Do you have a cousin named Sven?
What?
Never mind. Good night.
Excuse me, but it's only you again. My cousin Sven sends his regards.
I see. Let's talk business. You want to buy a map to the legendary lost treasure of Melee Island? Trademarked. Only one in existence. Rare. Very rare. Only 100 pieces of 8.
No thanks. I don't have enough money.
Well then buzz off, kid. It's bad for business.
So we need 100 pieces of 8. That's one thing we're trying to get done. Talk to the men of low moral fiber. Hey, nice rat.
Do you like rats?
Yes, I love rats.
They're very intelligent creatures. More intelligent than him. Well, there's a story around these parts of a bunch of rats actually crewed a ship from here, from fabled Monkey Island.
Nah, that's not right. It was actually a group of monkeys.
That's amazing.
But true. When they arrived, they sold the ship for a pretty penny. Only time I ever seen anyone get the better of Stan in a good old deal.
I thought it was rats. Do you guys know the sneaky-looking man on the opposite corner?
Wanna buy a map, eh? Our maps are top quality, not like from that birdcage liners you get from the clown across the street. Nah, just kidding. These are actually copies of the minutes of the last meetings of the Melee Island PTA. Can't even give them away. You want one?
No, but I'll take one if you give me 2 pieces of 8.
Okay, that's fair.
He gave us money to get rid of the last minutes of the PTA.
That's funny!
So, are you guys pirates?
Nah, we're a wandering circus troupe.
What does Rod Scoundrel wear the elephant?
Shut up!
Yeah, of course we're pirates. You can't buy the clothes like these at the rack.
What do you...
I forgot how the first guys sound. I'm an idiot.
It's the art of the deal.
I think the first guy was a cracky voice. I like how the middle guy is just ha 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 guy.
How come you're on this street corner, not on a ship? Looting, pillaging, sacking, that sort of thing.
Well, the pirates, they hasn't been playing out so well for us.
There are some unnaturally talented pirates in the area right now, operating out of Monkey Island. So we've been pursuing alternate means of self-support. We're trying to start up a circus.
It was really working out well until the rats got off the elephant. And now you've depressed us. Go home.
Gee, I wonder what's in these baskets. Actually, I'm not that curious to find out what's inside. Probably poisonous snakes. No thanks. I'd rather not touch any of this creepy voodoo stuff. Poor chickens. No thanks. Haven't you ever heard of salmonella? A rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle. What possible use could that have? Maybe no one will miss just this one thing.
We get to do our Jamaican accent finally. I'm not very good at the Jamaican accent. I'll try my best.
Why, I'll be fine. What may I help you with, son?
My name... Wait. Don't say anything. I can sense your name is Guybrush. Guybrush Nosehair, no? Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood, am I not right?
Wow, that was amazing. Do you know any other tricks?
I do not deal in tricks. What I know is the truth. So, my mind reading skills tell me it is your future you are interested in. Are you certain this is something you really wish to know?
No, don't tell me a thing. Life should be unexpected and exciting.
Suit yourself. Changed your mind, I see. I'm getting a vision. I see you taking a voyage, a long voyage. I see you captaining a ship.
Yeah!
I see...
What? You see what?
I see a giant monkey.
Yikes!
I see you inside the giant monkey.
Gross.
Wait! It is all becoming clear. Your journey will have many parts. You will see things better left unseen. You will hear things better left unheard. You will learn things better left unlearned.
What kind of things? I hate surprises.
No. The time is not right to know. When you know your purpose, come see me. I will let you know then.
Yikes!
What? She disappeared!
I fucking love this game.
Well, 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 if it isn't Mr. Chris Broad. I knew I could trick you to come out when I play a good game for once.
The Carnival of the Damned.
A Carnival of the Damned indeed. A Broad Chris has been subscribed for 5 months. Welcome to your doom. Well, I hope you enjoy it. We're doing an all voice acted version.
Oh, hi there, fancy pants.
Wait.
What do you want?
I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
Ah, the Swordmaster of Melee Island. I don't know. Nobody knows the whereabouts of her secret hideout. Nobody, except me. I'd have to go and ask her if it's okay to show you the way. I guess I could hike all the way over there. Once, I'll be right back. And don't touch anything.
All right, now actually, we're gonna pick up as much shit as we can. I better not touch it. That storekeeper guy might bite my head off. Hey, VK, what's up? Ooh, let's get the shovel. Ooh, we did get the shovel. Your voice acting is on point. I think this was my destiny, Chris, was to play Guybrush Threepwood. I can't pick that up. It doesn't seem to open. Get a handle on your savings with Grip Master Handles. Davy Jones Lockers, the last word in theft, fire, and grog-resistant storage devices. Ooh, the joy in Pete's eyes is effing inspiring. I just love this game. Ooh, a sword. Sweet. Ring bell for service. All right, well, we got two things.
Aha! Caught you, you little thief.
Ah, shit.
Maybe you'd like to pay for those.
Yeah, about this sword.
What about it?
I want it.
That's 100 pieces of 8. Take it or leave it.
I don't have enough money.
Then leave it. Figures. How else you want to waste my time?
About this shovel.
What about it?
How much is it?
Another would-be treasure hunter, eh? That'll cost you 75 pieces of 8.
75 pieces of 8? I don't have that much.
Then you'd better go and put it back.
All right, so we need about 175 pieces of 8. Then we can get a shovel and a sword. We need the shovel, I remember, for digging up the treasure huntery thing. We need the sword for the sword fighting. Loved the music from that one. Yeah, Grim Fandango is one of my favorite games as well, and so is Full Throttle. I think I just like to browse. So I know how we can find when...
Be my guest, Fancy Pants.
When the guy leaves the shop, I'm pretty sure we can follow him. Psst. Hello? Anybody in here? Hello?
You know, bad things could happen to a person in a dark, deserted alley like this one.
And at this time of night, nobody would be around to see it.
Yeah, and bad things happen to people who sneak up on other people from behind.
So, you're going to give me a little attitude, eh? I'd better get your name.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm new in town.
Listen, Peepweed. Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood. Whatever your name is, listen. I'm the sheriff around here, Sheriff Fester Shinetop. Take it from me, this is a bad time to be visiting Melee Island. A very bad time. My advice to you is to find somewhere else to take your vacation. Somewhere safer.
Boy, I feel much better knowing there's an officer of the law around.
Ooh.
Fester Shinetop.
Ooh, a circus. I'd love a circus.
I think tonight's more of like a, you know, hangout session anyway.
You gotta get me out of here. I'm a victim of society.
Not to mention halitosis.
Yuck.
Hey, it's hard to keep my breath minty fresh when there's something nothing to eat in here but rats. Okay, so this is Melee Island. There are different places to go around Melee Island. There's an island, a shore. You kind of got to figure out where, a clearing, a bridge, lights, and a house. Let's go to the clearing. Ooh. I think there's something going on in there.
I'd like to get in the cannon, but the gunpowder makes me a sneeze. Well, I cannot do it. I hurt my hand taming the lions last week. I hardly think that a little scratch compares to my chronic allergy. You get in the cannon.
Oh, no. I don't have any allergies, you fake hair. You get in the cannon.
No, you get in the cannon.
No, you get in the cannon.
Slacker. Loser. Ruffian. Fop. Weasel. Weevil. Miscreant. Toadier. Ne'er-do-well. Scuffler. Mullethead. Millethead. Pencilhead. Halfhead. Cheesehead. Howpear.
What? Just get in the canyon.
No, you get in the canyon. No, you get in the canyon. Your mother wears combat slippers. Leave our mother out of it, you get in the canyon. No, you get in the canyon. No, you get in the canyon. You're a chicken. You're a dead chicken. Well, if you're a dead chicken, then with a pulley in the middle. What? Just get in the canyon. No, you get in the canyon. No, you get in the canyon. No, you get in the canyon.
We did it. We got
Weasel. Weevil.
Let me see him. Does this place have a bathroom?
Say there, Sanon. You look like a joint in the left arm to perform an amazing feat or a death-defying feat. Well, not so death-defying, really. A dangerous feat. No, not so dangerous. It's an easier feat, but exciting. With the amazing, adventurous, and acrobatic, and exceedingly well-known family behind Fettuccine Brazzers. My brother Alfredo and my brother Bill. Sound good? Good. It's very simple, really. You see, that cannon over there. All you have to do is get in the cannon and we'll shoot you out of here. Across the room. Quite safe, actually.
How much will you pay me?
How about 747 pieces of earth?
Well, we do need the money. Okay, sounds good.
Have you got a helmet?
Of course I have a helmet. What sort of idiot do you take me for?
Well, let's have it. We want to be sure that it's safe. We wouldn't want you to hurt your nosari.
Ah, that will work as he want. We can do the trick. Step right over here, son. Now, put on your helmet and get in the canal. And we'll take care of the rocks.
Echo, 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 echo.
It works! I am so relieved. Hey, are you okay?
I'm bad, Newman. Are you not my mother?
He's all right. Hooray, we are spared an embarrassing and financially debilitating loss here. Here's your money, sir. Just a recompense for aiding us. We just need to change the aim little bit. I'll try next. No, I'll do next. No, me. No, me. Slacker. Loser. Ruffian. Fop.
Go to this shore.
I like to buy hamburger. Hamburger. Hamburger.
Visit the fabulous Hook Isle. Restrooms, souvenirs. Oh wait, I can look at it. Gaudy, but in a cheerful sort of way. So look. This thing right here, we're going to use our chicken on the cable. Give me back my burger. Wait. Give me back my burger. Open.
Hey. I don't like visitors. Who are you?
I'm Bobbin Threadbare. Are you my mother?
No, mother was a duck. Now beat it.
He had a, he still has the brain damage. I'm Bobbin Threadbare. Are you my mother? I'm a pirate, Cannonball Head. Who are you?
My name's Meat Hook. And I think you've got a little attitude problem.
Well, I think you've got a little hair problem.
Jeez, you just don't know when to quit, do you?
Obviously, neither did your barber.
Why, you... I suppose you've come to invade my peaceful home and insult me again, eh?
Excuse me, but the sign said that there were restrooms in here.
Sorry, but that sign's a little out of date. I used to have a thriving tourist business here. I had animal acts, tattoo demonstrations, souvenirs. But there was a little accident with one of the trained animals. One of our guests was hurt very badly. So I was shut down, put out of business. And since then, I've lived here alone. And the only company I have is the same beast that mauled that unlucky tourist. The same beast that made me a hermit. A monster that, just by coincidence, is identical to one that attacked me when I was just a child. And left me with these hooks instead of hands. A deformed man. Ah, jeez. Now I'm all depressed. Thanks a lot. Can't you just leave me alone now?
Whoops, I just realized that this is the wrong house.
Oh, okay. Have a nice time on Melee Island.
Yes, I did. Wait, use breath... No, wait. Give breath mints to...
Ooh, Brago Mint. How refreshing. Thanks. So, have you come to release me?
are you?
My name is Otis. At least, I think it is. I've been in here so long I can hardly remember. You've got to get me out of here before I lose my mind completely. Can't you see I'm innocent?
But why are you in jail if you're innocent?
I was framed. I didn't touch the stupid flowers.
What flowers?
The yellow Caniche Indormi flowers in the forest. It's against the law to pick them.
Well, can I get you anything?
Yes. You can get me out of here!
Actually, something to get rid of these rats would be nice. I'll trade you this carrot cake my Aunt Tilly made. I hate carrot cake.
Sheriff Shinetop sure is a jerk, isn't he?
No kidding. Festus Shinetop is the meanest man on Melee Island. Luckily, the governor keeps him in check most of the time. We used to have a fair, decent man for a sheriff. But he recently died under mysterious circumstances. If you ask me, I think that the new sheriff had something to do with it.
I think you've said enough, Otis.
Oh, whoops.
I hope you haven't been talking to this filthy vagrant too seriously. I'd say anything to avoid paying his debt to society.
He seems innocent to me. Why don't you let him out?
Maybe you should mind your own business, stranger. I'll decide who's innocent and who's guilty around here.
Sorry.
Look, I don't know what you're up to. But whatever it is, it's probably illegal, so forget it. Wherever you go on Melee, I'll be watching. And if you try in monkey business, you'll end up in here for good.
Man, is he a pill or what?
You see what I have to put up with? You'd better go before you both get us in trouble.
Interesting. Sheriff is sus.
I think so. I actually don't really remember his involvement in the game. But the previous sheriff, who was good and fair, is now dead.
Where does he even keep the carrot cake?
You don't want to know.
Excuse me, but do you... Oh, it's you again. Come back here for the map of the legendary lost treasure of Mainland Island, eh? Hope you brought enough money this time.
I'll take it!
It'll make a swell gift.
There you go. You made a wise decision. Now get lost.
Look at the map.
I think I've been had. This is no map. It looks like... dancing lessons.
Do the monkey. Back. 2, 3, 4. Left. 2, 3, 4. Right. 2, 3, 4.
There you have it. We got screwed. Way to go us. I'm Guybrush Threepwood. I came to Melee Island because I want to be a pirate.
Well, you picked the right place for it, though perhaps the wrong time. Not to mention the wrong name. You have the silliest name I've heard in a long time.
Call me Squinky.
You just said you were Gibberish Driftwood, or something like that.
Guybrush Threepwood.
Sure, whatever.
Who are you?
I'm the lookout of Melee Island. I watch the ocean for approaching storms and ships and report them directly to the governor. She doesn't like unexpected visitors, especially not now.
How did you get to be the lookout when you're obviously blind as a bat?
Watch your tongue. I was handpicked by Sheriff Shinetop.
I'm over here.
I'll just be off to seek my fortune now. Good luck.
Stand aside, troll. I'm a mighty pirate.
You're no pirate. Well, the town drunk could out-insult you on his back. And probably would.
What do you guys think? Scottish or Statham Troll? Statham Troll or Scottish?
Tommy, the tit, was praying. And if he's not, he fucking should be.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You know, you could stand a lesson or two if that's the best you can come up with. None shall pass. You can't pass until you pay the toll.
How much is the toll?
Well, what have you got?
Some semi-rancid meat? A rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle? Don't mess with me, troll, I'm a mighty pirate. 30 pieces of eight? 204 pieces of eight? Nothing of consequence. Never mind, I'll have to go now. I'll try some semi-rancid meat. Some semi-rancid meat?
I want something that will attract attention, but have no real importance.
Construction paper jockey shorts?
Don't be silly. You have three chances to give me what I want. Then, I eat ya.
Oh no, he's gonna thump me. Pick up fish. I think that bird will peck my hand off. That doesn't seem to work. There is a way to get rid of that fish. Whack it off, stab the bird. I don't think you can. There's a plank. I thought you could... Yay, I remembered. There you go. Now, what do I want to do with this fish? Let me look at it. I think it's a herring. It's literally a red herring. So you mean it's useless? I'm going to have that thing the whole time, you think? I'll just have that in my possession the entire game? Already ringing that stupid bell. What do you want? I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island. Look, I told you, she doesn't want to see you. Maybe if you asked her again. I guess I could hike all the way over there. Again. Be right back. All right, and don't touch anything. So now, this time, we're going to follow him. Whoops. Ah, classic puzzles. You just don't get them like this anymore. Better stay back here and listen what they have to say.
Hello again, Carla. I thought I told you to get lost. Actually, I'm here on business. This kid came into my store, see? Face it, you crusty old lech. You'd make any excuse to come out here and bother me.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, cut it out. I'm sick of it. take a hike, and don't come out here again. Someone might follow you, and then I'd be in another Melee Island tourist attraction.
Well, it's your loss, baby.
Yeah, right. Now scram. Let's go talk to Carla. The Sword Master. How dare you approach the Sword Master without permission? Which I surely didn't give you. I beg your pardon? I must talk to you. I doubt that. Everyone who comes here is prepared to fight. Let's be honest, you're here to prove yourself to the pirate leaders in hopes of one day being as immoral as they are. Yep, nailed it. Right on the head. Gee, you're smart. What was your final grade in Captain Smirk's sword fighting class? Grade? Class? You mean you came here to take on the Swordmaster of Melee Island? Possibly the greatest sword fighter in the entire Caribbean. Without a single lesson in the art of fencing. Yep. And how did you expect to defend yourself? Gee, I don't know. I see. Obviously, not with your razor-sharp wit. I'd advise you to seek out Captain Smirks and get some real training. It would hardly be ethical, sporting, or even interesting to fight someone as unskilled as yourself. So beat it. Right, left, back. Cha-cha-cha. Wait, what? Right, left, back. Okay. The legendary lost treasure of Melee Island. This carefully reproduced piece of Melee Island history has delighted thousands of would-be pirates and their families for generations. Remember, there are other pirates on this island. So go easy on the treasure. Leave some for the next person. So stupid. It's a tourist attraction. Here lies treasure of such unimaginable wealth. Well, you'll just have to dig it up to believe it. Paid for by the Melee Island Chamber of Commerce. Well, use Shumvel with X. Oh, this shouldn't take too long. Hours pass. He really is Peter. Hey, I think I hit something. Oh boy. It's a t-shirt. Not my size, but a nice one nonetheless. Well, I guess I better put all this dirt back now. I found the treasure of Melee Island, and all I got was this stupid t-shirt. Monkey Island, baby. This game is the best. Give. Ah, a red herring. Pass. It did work. Yes! That's funny. He's Pelican Man, too! We did it, gamers! Grog. Diet Grog. Cherry Grog. Grog Classic. Caffeine-free Grog. And root beer. Oh wow, a grog vending machine! Welcome to Stan's previously owned vessels. I'm off searching the globe right now for the finest in previously owned marine transportation. Have a look around. I'll be right back. Stan.
Thirsty. Let's look at some of the boats. Look at boat, as is. Ah, a fixer-upper. You've never had root beer? Now that's a nice looking vessel. Looks like one of those well-engineered imports. I'm surprised this one is still afloat. Fuel coming. Dull, dull, dull. It's the fuel economy version. Much better like this. Both, I think, you guys were talking, let me see the grog machine in HD. Wow. I think both look good, honestly. But if you did have to pick which one I think is better, it's this one. Let's try this house at the end. Maybe this is the other version. Ah, here's the sword fighting place. Okay. Captain Smirk's Big Body Pirate Gym. Prices. Sword training, 30 pieces of 8. Cannon firing, 160 pieces of 8. Balls are extra. Grappling hook, 130 pieces of 8. Hook, extra. I think I'll knock. It'd only be polite. What do you want, you wimpy little spineless maggot? Can we step inside? It's a little bit chilly out here. What did you say? I said it's a little chilly out here. You're right, I could catch a cold. What do you want? Could you please put out that cigar? It's not good for your health, and it smells terrible. Sure, I'd love to put it out. In your face. Maybe I'll just leave instead. Good idea. What do you want? Could you train me to be better than the Swordmaster? Better than the Swordmaster. You! You could never be half of the fighter that Carla is. Even with hours of hard work and sweat and blood. I remember fighting side by side with Carla at Port Royal. And the local constable had late constabulary had us cornered. It looked like we were down for, but then she said, but I digress. You just don't have what it takes. Unless it's a farm. And you know, you should really quit smoking. I do so have what it takes. You do not. I do so. You do not. I do so. I like your spirit. I'll do what I can. Of course, it'll cost you. What have you got? I've got 30 pieces of 8. Say no more. Say no more. Let's see your sword. Okay, check it out. Yes, this is a nice one. Let's get to it. Okay, you maggot! Why don't you whip that sword out and let's see what you can do with it? Boy, you fight like a dairy farmer. I usually don't waste my time with vermin like yourself. But
Seeing as this LeChuck thing has put a cramp on my business, I've got no choice. I need the money. Yes. I can see this is going to take some special measures. Just want you to know, I don't do this with everyone. It's only because I feel that special student-mentor pieces of eight bonding that I'm going to these links. I'm going to put you up against the machine. Machine? Is this going to hurt? Yikes! Come at me, don't be afraid, you won't hurt me. Distance! Distance! Watch your footwork. Use your forte against the foible. Advance, thrust, recover, parry, riposte. No, beat first, then lunge.
Hours later.
You're starting to get the hang of it.
More hours later.
Not bad, you've got good form. Now, I'm gonna let you in on the true secret of sword fighting. Sword fighting is kind of like making love. It's not always what you do, but what you say. A fool pirate can swing a sharp piece of metal around and hope to cut something. But the pros, they know just when to cut their opponent with an insult. And one that catches him off guard. You see, kid, you've got what it takes to be twice as sharp as your sword. What's up, Zutu? Hey, hey, let's try a couple of insults out, shall we? Okay. Imagine this. We're fighting up a storm, just like Carla and I were doing at Port Royale. There's a sudden break in the fighting, and I say to you, you fight like a dairy farmer. You respond with, oh yeah? So's your mother. I'm rubber and you're glue. You must be thinking of someone else. I'm not a farmer. He doesn't know the words. So insult sword fighting is critically important. Let's say that Guybrush is completely stupid. You must be thinking of someone else. I'm not a farmer. I can see that we've got a lot to do here. You should have responded with something like, how about, how appropriate, you fight like a cow, you see? It's razor-sharp wit like that that wins fights. Let's try another. Imagine this. You're trapped up against a wall. My sword just slashed two cuts into your face. I say, soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab. You respond with, oh yeah? So is your mother. I'm rubber and you're glue. How appropriate, you fight like a cow. Appropriate, you fight like a cow. Just here for the ride. No. See, that was the response from the first insult. Doesn't even make sense when it's used here. A correct response to, soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab, would have been something like, I don't know. First, you'd better stop waving it around like a feather duster. See? Razor sharp. Now I suggest you go out there and learn some insults. Well, I can't help but feel like I've been ripped off. Well, I'm sure you're feeling something similar. On our quest to be a mighty pirate, we heard of an undead LeChuck. LeChuck seems to be a pirate who's after the heart of the mayor, Elaine. Why is this important? How will this come into play? I'm not sure. Stay tuned to find out. So now we fight and learn some insults. By finding random... This is like listening to an audiobook. Well, I hope so. I hope you guys are enjoying the intense efforts that I'm putting in to sound remotely good. I think I should play this game. It's very fun. Move out of the way or I cut my way through. My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. Okay, so now I have to start using my insults
against him. Feet, when they see me coming, even before they smell your breath? I give up! You win!
Our first victory.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
You run that fast?
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
How appropriate. You fight like a cow.
You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me.
I give up! You win!
Hey, this better be important.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die.
People fall at my feet. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
I got this scar on my face during a mighty struggle.
I'm shaking.
Shit.
You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'm rubber. You're glue.
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
All right, we gotta get a few more of these guys. This is the way these old games worked. The first one I wanna get is the Mighty Struggle.
I've got this scar on my face during a mighty struggle.
I hope you've learned to stop picking your nose.
I'm not gonna take your insolence sitting down.
What, your hemorrhoids flaring up again?
That's the actual response, I believe. That we don't have.
And I've got a tip for you. Get the point?
I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
Oh yeah?
I'm not going to take your insolence sitting down.
Your hemorrhoids are flaring up again, eh?
Peter, you rusco.
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
Uh-oh, I'm rubber, you're glue. The reversal!
This is like high school all over again.
Soon, you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab.
First, you better stop waving it around like a feather duster.
People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
Could you repeat that? I didn't quite get it.
I said people fall at my feet when they see me coming.
I'm shaking.
That's not the word. You have the manners of a beggar.
How appropriate, you fight like a cow.
I give up! You win!
So now we fight another guy.
Stomping a pirate can be dangerous for your health.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die.
So now I'm going to use the words that I just learned from that guy, and I'm going to try to use them against him and get the correct insult back. You have the manners of a beggar.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me. This is the end for you, you gutter-crawling cur.
I'm rubber, you are glue.
My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
So you got that job as a janitor after all?
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
I'm glad to hear you attended your family reunion.
It takes time, guys. But we're slowly learning some new insults.
1 eternity later.
How dare you approach the Swordmaster with... Oh, it's you again. My name is Guybrush Threepwood. I've come to kill you. Nothing like being honest. I can tell by the sarcastic expression on your face that you've been fully trained by Captain Smirk. Let's get this over with. I usually see people like you passed out on tavern floors. So the combat in this game is all insult sword fighting. You're gonna hear an insult and you gotta reply with a witty thing. I usually see people like the first one and we are out. I know, she's the sword master. I usually see people like you passed out on tavern floors. So you got that job as a janitor after all? That's funny, I thought. My tongue is sharper than any sword. Well, and I've got a little tip for you, get the point? Oh no. My name is feared in every dirty corner of this island.
She beat us 3-0!
We'll try janitor again. So you got that job as a janitor after all! There we go. My last fight ended with my hands covered in blood. I hope you've now learned to stop picking your nose. I will milk every drop of blood from your body. Your hemorrhoids are flaring up again? I will milk every cow. Yeah, it's gotta be cow. How appropriate, you fight like a cow. I hope you have a boat ready for a quick escape. Why? Did you want to borrow one? It's probably run fast. You run that fast? I think borrow... Borrow might be the way to go. Right? What did she say? Wait, what did she say? She said... I forgot what she said already. This game is wholesome and surprisingly fun. It's a really great game. Yeah, I first played this when I was like 9. Ah, quick escape. I think it'd be borrow. Because running that fast means I'm still scared. Honestly, this stream, heck, Pete is hands down the best streamer I have ever seen. I've never laughed so hard in all me life. Oh, Broving, that's a very, very, very high compliment. Thank you, my man. Why did you want to borrow one?
Burrow! No one will ever catch me fighting as badly as you do. No one will ever catch me fighting as badly as you do. Now it's run. No one will ever catch me fighting as bad as you do. Yeah. You run that... You can go back and brag to your friends about how you beat the sword master. You'll need proof. Here, this should convince them. Yes! Way to go, dudes. Well done. That was fun.
Nice shot!
Thank you. Big brain chat. We did it, boys. We finally beat the maniac swordmaster woman. She's very, very strong. That was so cool. The only thing I like about the remaster version is the ambient music. And we got another t-shirt. Let's take a look.
Nice shot.
Thank you. It says, I beat the swordmaster. Hold on. Let's give the t-shirt to important looking pirates. Discover the lost treasure, eh? You're a clever boy. You may keep that chic t-shirt. We have plenty. I'm the deadliest scallywag that ever swung a sword. Well, defeated the sword master, did ye? You're a strong fellow. You may keep the stylish t-shirt. We have enough. Tell me more about mastering the art of thievery.
We wanted to procure a small item for us.
The idol of many hands.
In the governor's mansion. The governor keeps the idol of many hands on display case in a mansion outside of town.
You'll have to get past the guards, naturally.
The tricky part will be getting past the dogs outside.
They're a particularly vicious breed. You might be able to drug them or something.
Maybe the carrot cake that one guy has? Maybe we can trade the carrot. Maybe we can give this guy maybe dogs don't like carrot cake.
I don't want anything but my freedom. Coming to go interrogate the prisoner again, eh?
So, how's the food in there?
Oh, you know, the usual. Slop, grog, gruel, rats, bugs, and body lice, if I can catch them. I have a carrot cake from my Aunt Tillamade, even though she knows I detest carrot cake. Actually, the cook at the bar is an old friend of mine, and sometimes he sneaks me food. Like pork trimmings, mostly feet and lips, but once in a while, he brings me a really odd rump roast.
What was so odd about the rump roast?
Well, it's the only rump roast I've ever seen with a prehensile tail.
So, who'd want to frame you?
I don't know who exactly. I think it was a conspiracy. And if there's one type of piracy I don't like, it's conspiracy. Look, I've like visitors and everything, but I don't have much more to say. Plus, my throat's getting all dry from this talking. Why don't you go find someone else to talk to? It's not like that I'm the only pirate left on this island or anything.
Ye old rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle shop. Serving your rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle needs for over 50 years.
We finally battled through insult sword fighting and we got a t-shirt that says we beat the sword master. Second, we found the hidden treasure buried in the middle of the... And then the third thing is the thievery. We know it's in the governor's mansion, but we don't know exactly how to get past the dogs. They need to be drugged, but we're not familiar with how to drug them. I have one more idea I'm about to check out and we'll see if that works. The thing is, I forgot.
Ooh, that's refreshing. It's gotta be this thing. It's gotta be this poison barrel. I think it's full of that foul stuff pirates drink. Mincemeat. That's actually a pretty clever idea. Now we can keep the meat. I don't see anything special about it. Maybe the chef has something on him? Let's try to talk to him inside.
Hey! You can't come back here!
Beat the meat! That could be what we need. Are you gonna prepare before the big game? No. My, what unusually bright yellow they are. That doesn't seem to work. Maybe there's something poisonous here. Damn it. What do you call the security outside of a Samsung store? Guardians of the galaxy. Well done.
I suppose you've come to invade my peaceful home and insult me again, eh?
What was your name again, Cannonballhead?
Look, I told you not to call me that. My name's Meathook. And you still have a little attitude problem.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to call you Cannonballhead.
Well, it's okay. I'd rather have a Cannonballhead than a ponytail.
I meant to call you Chrome Dome.
Why, you son of a... I had to insult him. He made fun of my ponytail. I'd rather have a cannonball head than a ponytail.
Oh, you've got a pretty good sense of humor, mate.
You want to see something really funny?
Like what? A picture of your whole bald family?
Oh, it's bait. I can't go with it. He'll kick me out. We're never going to make the progress through this.
Like what? A picture of your whole bald family?
Jeez, you don't know when to quit, do you?
Obviously, neither did your barber. I'm sorry. I was just trying to be funny.
You want to see something funny?
I'm good, I'm working.
Say hello, Roger.
Hello, Roger.
Pretty good, right? I got a whole routine. Well, I don't want, have the time to do it all right now. Maybe if we ever go on a long ocean voyage together. But until then, I'm a very busy man, so...
Could you show me that neato tattoo thing again? I'll give him a different voice.
Well... Okay, just one more time. Watch this. So, hello, Roger.
Hello, Roger. Uh-huh.
Whoops, I just realized that this is the wrong house.
You're okay, mate. Well, have a nice time on Melee Island. Say goodbye, Roger.
Goodbye, Roger.
He's got a talking tattoo on his chest.
So we've got to make sure we poison this thing. I don't think we have anything right now that's poisonous. What? I did a let. It's a striking yellow color.
It's mustard!
It was the yellow plant! I didn't know we picked it up! did it myself. Big Brain Pete. Now this should work. It's some sort of meat or meat-like substance. Give meat with condiments to deadly piranha poodles. Ha! Important notice, these dogs are not dead, they are only sleeping. No animals were harmed during the production of this game. Yes! Ah, they're sleeping, peacefully. A priceless Ming. This looks like a job for Fester Shinetop. Better leave this here. Hypnotize quarrelsome rhinoceroses? Push red button? No, not the red button! There's like little text things. Look at the tremendous yak! It's a big, ugly, hairy yak, wearing some wax lips. Push tremendous, dangerous yak? I can't move it. Pull tremendous, dangerous looking yak? I can't move it. Walk to, pick up, staple remover. Use staple remover on tremendous, dangerous looking yak. Walk to books. Pick up, manual of style. I'll need this. I must be nuts! Pick up wax lips. Walk to. Gophers! Gopher repellent. Use gopher repellent with gopher. Another gopher. Gopher horde. Little funny man. Look at fabulous idol. It's beautiful. Open lock. I can't open it. Uh-oh. Pick up heavy chair. Walk to. Use heavy chair with sheriff. Well, that should hold him for a while. If only I had a file, I could get the idol. What a game. Guybrush smash! Maybe we can give the gopher repellent to the guy. Give gopher repellent to prisoner. Hey! This might work on the rats! Thanks! Here's the cake. The cake has the file to help him get out! She was trying to help him escape prison! It's heavy. Oh, of course! It's a raspy metal file. No, I'd better not wear it out before I get the idol. Okay, hold on, I need to... Well, I locked the sheriff in there. Not good. Ah, maybe we just go jump in this thing. I've got the file. Oh! Use Manual of Style with Shredder. Give stylish confetti to heavily armed clown. Whee! Throw wax lips in fire. Use file on rhinoceros toenails. Use file on lock. Pick up fabulous idol. Walk to... Whew! That was a close one. At least I got the idol. But I'm not done with you yet. Uh-oh. Thought you could get out of here with the idol of many hands, did you? Look, I can explain. So can I. You poisoned the governor's pet poodles. They're just sleeping. Broke into her house. The door was unlocked. And stole one of her most valuable pieces of art. No. You've got it all wrong.
Oh, really?
Let's hear your explanation. It belongs in a museum. Huh. What's going
Alert.
On here?
The center control point is being captured.
Oh, shit. I caught this. He says it belongs in a museum. That's right. It does. One moment, please. What? You heard me, Festa. The real question is, how did he get in here while you were on guard? 1 second, man. Just go away, Festa. I can handle this. I'll deal with you later. I'm sorry about him. He's new. I'm Governor Marley. So, my idol belongs in a museum, eh? Oh! It belongs in a museum! Gosh. What would I say? Confronted by a beautiful, I'm a sexy woman. Gee. Relax, Mr. Threepwood. I know why you're here. Believe me, you're not the first who's tried. Although I have to admit, not many get as far as you have. Jeepers. My lookout told me of your arrival. I've wanted to meet you ever since I heard your fascinating name. Tell me, Guybrush, why do you want to be a pirate? You don't look like one. Your face is too... sweet. Which one do you guys think? Blift, glipped, hurdle, or riled? Glipped. I see. Well, you're obviously not in the mood for idle chit-chat, are you? I suppose you've got many more exciting things to do. I won't take up any more of your time, Mr. Threepwood. Idiot Guybrush. Murph naked foof. Dimly. I really wish I knew how to talk to women. He was afraid of talking to her, Yuji. He got nervous. Where do you think you're going, Threewald? I'm going to put this idol in my safe deposit box. You know, it's not too late for us to make up and be friends. Excuse me, Mr. Shinetop, but you're blocking the doorway. Buzz off, Fester. Natural plea.
I'm the natural.
Man, I like Guybrush a lot.
Me too.
Which one do you think here? Buzz off, Fester.
I think you need to cool off. Hand over your sword.
Uh-oh.
This is the end of the road, my little pantalooned pal. Your troublemaking days on Melee Island are over. My plans for the governor are far too important and much too near complete and to risk letting a would-be pirate like you get in the way. So long, Mr. Spice Cake or Droop Face or whatever your name was. Blah! Huh. This might actually turn out to be a pretty good day.
So, interesting thing about this game is that Guybrush Threepwood, they asked, do you guys remember what he said at the very beginning of the game? Walk up to deadly meat cleaver. Sharp and dangerous. Pick up. I can't reach it from here. Very sharp. Pick up the scissors. I can't reach it. He can breathe underwater for 10 minutes. This is the part where you can die. There's an axe. It's heavy and sharp. Yeah, I can't reach it from here. No, it's sharp. I better be careful. It's a rusty knife. Yeah, pick it up. Ooh, it looks sharp. So, this is actually an interesting puzzle. Let's see how it looks. Ooh.
I can't reach that from here. I can't reach that from here.
Do you guys know how to beat it? Oh, use the stapler remover. No staples to be removed. The game is just teasing the shit out of you. Now, I know how to solve this puzzle.
Hey, Nick, I just committed a felony. Did it involve that big knife you've got there?
Yeah.
What should I do with it?
Get rid of it, mate.
I'll throw it in the water.
No. Don't do that.
Why not? I need to ditch it.
It might wash up somewhere.
What do I care?
My prince won't be on it. I'm throwing it in.
Nah, I might need it. See ya.
He might need it. Or do you want to see Guybrush die? Like, do you want to see the hidden little cutscene that shows it when he dies? Guybrush! Shovel the anchor point, maybe? Wait, he actually dies after 10 minutes? Yes! When did we save this? Have you tried just picking up the idol? And that, my friends, is the answer. You just have to pick up the fabulous idol and walk out. Gee, I don't know how much longer I can hold my breath. That's it. You just pick up the idol and walk out. God damn it. Nice. Adventure Gaming Logic. How did you know I was playing it? Poor Guybrush. He can survive exactly 10 minutes. This is morbid. Don't you want to see the little cutscene? I don't want to see. No, we can't let Guybrush die. I won't have it. That'll be a... Guess I'll be needing this sword. No, I can't. He's my hero. What was that? I'm so confused.
Hey,
Hey, what are you doing just standing around? The governor's been kidnapped.
What? By whom?
LeChuck's got her on that ship and just sailed off. He caught her alone when she came down here to rescue you. I'm afraid we've seen the last of her.
So, where were you this whole time? Sleeping?
Look, I'm a lookout, not a bodyguard.
Why don't you think we'll ever see her again?
LeChuck's taken the governor back to his hideout on Monkey Island, TM. I'm afraid that no pirate on this island is brave enough to follow him there. But, hey, good luck. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. They left this note. You can have it, but I don't think you'll like what it says.
Oh, Governor, why did you have to risk your life for me? Maybe you cared for me more than I thought. Just as I now realize how much I care for you. It's my fault that the Governor's in this mess, and I swear I'll get her out of it. Even if I have to sail to Monkey Island, trademarked, myself to get her. Attention, Pirates of Melee. Your governor is alive and well and by my side as she was always meant to be. If I try to find us, you will only meet with a horrifying disaster. Yours truly, Captain LeChuck. What?
Hey, dreams are cool. They let you know about how you do and stuff. I don't remember this.
What's wrong, old sot?
The governor's gone. LeChuck and his spectral crew came and got her. They put her on the ghost ship and they spared her away. She was so good to me. Always conveniently losing those health board reports. For small consideration, of course. So what will become of me business? Oh, woe is me. What can I do to save her? You must get a ship and go after her. The ghost pirate flares on Monkey Island, everybody knows that. Oh, don't ask me how. All you need to do is find a way there.
We got a little caught up at figuring out how to poison the dogs, but I got lucky and remembered that you kind of get mustard and throw it on there and then chuck the meat. That one took us a while, but now we're trying to... Governor Marley has been kidnapped. The governor's been kidnapped. What? Here, look at this note.
They've kidnapped the governor? This really makes me mad. I feel like kicking someone. I wonder if she left her place unlocked.
If I let you out, would you join my pirate crew?
Sure. Of course. To my emancipator, I shall be eternally indebted. Until then, I pace.
Talk to the sword master.
You've already got the t-shirt. What do you want now?
The governor's been kidnapped.
What? That's ridiculous. Oh, no. This looks bad. Very bad.
I'm getting a ship and a crew together to go rescue her.
I have a feeling I'm going to regret this, but... Count me in. I'll meet you at the dock.
We got a crew member.
Having just returned from Melee, LeChuck and his crew find their old hiding place in the underground rivers of Monkey Island and drop anchor.
Captain, sir, I just stopped by to congratulate you on your kidnapping mission.
Captain.
Captain, are you all right?
Never felt better. And how fares our prisoner?
Ah, yes, the prisoner. We had a little trouble. Nothing to worry about, sir. Everything's under control. She escaped a few times, but we've got her locked up in the brig. No one's getting in or out of there.
For your sake, I hope not. With years of planning almost destroyed by my death, I'm not taking any chances now.
You took care of Mr. Threepwood, then?
Guybrush Threepwood will not be a problem. At this very moment, he's 20 feet underwater, probably bloated up like a fattened pig. His eyes being eaten out by crabs, fish pecking at his fingers. Kinda makes you wish you were there to watch.
Ah, yes, sir. Sure does at that.
Now, go check on the route. Make sure it's locked up tight.
Aye, aye, Captain.
What was that? A skin suit?
Yes. So that's why old Fester Shinetop is no friend of ours. Now, let's go talk to Meat Hook.
Arr, mateys.
I told you, I don't have the time to show you more tattoo tricks. The governor's been kidnapped. What? That's preposterous. Oh, really? How dare you? Take a look at this note they left.
Oh no, Master Bruce. This is horrible.
What are we going to do? I was hoping you would have an idea. We could just wait here for them to come back. We could get a crew together and sail after them. We'd become overcome with despair and just give up.
Oh, this one solution. Wait. I know. We could get a ship and a crew and go rescue her.
Oh, what an idea.
Now, if only we had a captain.
What about me?
You? Oh, that's a good one.
Hey, I'm serious.
Really?
Really?
Okay, let's see, prove it. Walk this way. There's something in here that I want to show you. Something horrible. Something so horrible that I stay awake at night just thinking about it. Well, I don't mean to scare you. I'm sure a big brave guy like yourself will have no problem facing this monster. After all, it's much smaller than the beast that bit off my hands so many years ago. Let's just hope that you're quicker than I was. What's up, Loco Sudo? I just remembered something. I never did get around to feeding him this week. Silly me. I'll let you open this last door by yourself. Just let me get out of your way.
Wait, getting cold feet? No, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Well, you're supposed to open that little door, and if you're brave enough, touch the beast inside.
Oh, is that all?
Okay, go ahead. If you've got the guts.
Walk to the murderous winged devil.
Oh, I don't believe it.
You're a brave man than I thought. You faced this beast I feared all these years.
You had the guts to do what I never could. Oh, I feel like such a coward. I'm not good enough to be on your crew. Oh, I'm not even good enough to swab your decks.
Ow, come on, Meat Hook. You're a big, strong, good-looking guy with a talking tattoo. You can swab my decks anytime.
Really?
Sure.
Oh, I can still be on your crew.
Just pack your stuff and meet me at the dock.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, mate. Oh, I won't let you down. Hey, maybe I'll get a chance to show you my whole tattoo routine when we're on the sea.
Wow, this is sounding better and better all the time. So, here's how you get the guy. Remember what they said about Grog? You guys remember what they said about Grog? Anybody? That's my hint for you. What about Grog? It's like there's not a lot of people who can remember this clue. So I'm just going to give you guys, it's very corrosive, right? And why would we need it to be corrosive? To burn through the bars at the jail station.
Hey, great, a drink. I'm really thirsty.
Yikes!
Wow. And to think I used to drink that stuff. I'm free. Oh, yeah, thanks. Sucker.
But, oh, do we still have a deal?
No, I'm sure he'll be back. He gave me his word as a pirate.
So that guy was free and then dipped on us. Well, that sucks. Can we let the rat out too? The rat stays.
I don't believe that for a second. We should get a studio together.
Can I play the drums? Can I be there? So there is some cool new music things happening on this channel that I can't wait to share with you guys, but it's going to be for a while. And actually, one of the things that's most said about me is I have one of the most, at the school I teach at, I definitely have the loudest voice known to mankind. Second is the, I don't play drums. I played them in junior high school. I had a snare drum and they kicked me out of a mandatory elective class that I signed up for. They just said, you should just stop this class and take something else. So that's not cool. I even took my snare drum once to Ern's house on like summer vacation to practice in his garage. And I played it for about 5 minutes. And I mean, not mandatory elective. I signed up for the elective. And okay. Wow. Ooh, hey, cool. Look at us. Hey, everybody, timeout.
Oh, did he say mandatory elective? Yeah, I think he did. High five, cool bro. Well, that's so funny because mandatory elective's like an oxymoron. I know. Pete was just trying to tell a story and we go over every single little word that he says. I know, it's my favorite thing. Every time Pete's talking, I look for like the smallest little hiccup. You look up for a hiccup too? That's what I'm doing. And when he f***s up, we all like say it in the chat together and he has to explain himself even though we knew exactly. Oh, no, because we knew exactly what he was saying. Haha, you're the best, dude. No, dude, you're the best. Haha, we're the best.
So I think we've got our group, right?
Howdy. I'm Stan of Stan's Previously Owned Vessels.
And I'd stand on my head to make you a deal. What sort of craft are you looking for?
Big, little, fast, slow.
You want it? I got it.
And if I don't got it, I'll get it.
I want to make your deal that you're happy with.
Because if you're not happy, I'm not happy. But I know you're going to leave here happy today. How do I know?
Just look at all these ships. I've got something for everyone. Come, take a look around.
I love Stan. Stan's one of my favorite guys.
So tell me. What are you interested in looking at today? Let me see the best ship you've got.
Hey, it's nice to meet a man who appreciates quality.
Ah, just got the boat for you. Walk this way. Talk this way. Now this is the ship fit for a king.
I mean, we're talking 15 staterooms, a fireplace in every one. We're talking two pools, one indoor, one outdoor. We're talking rotating ballroom. We're talking heated crow's nest. We're talking 200 feet of ocean-going decadence. And all for one low price. Speaking of price, how much would you like to spend? Money is no object. Actually, I was hoping to get one on credit. Oh, no, I have more, no more than 174 pieces of eight. The outdoor pool is just the ocean, right? All I have is this rubber chicken. On second thought, maybe this might not be the ship for me. All I have is this rubber chicken. Is it one of those rubber chickens with a pulley in the middle? I already got one of those. You wouldn't happen to have any other means of finance, would you? Yeah, on second thought, this might not be the ship for me. Well, heck, I can understand that. Nothing wrong with being indecisive. Pete knows all about that, even if it is a waste of my time. So, what else can I show you? I want to go through all the options. That spiffy blue one by the office. That one looks nice. Of course it does. It's mine. And it's not for sale. What else can I show you? Something not too expensive, but built to last. Affordable quality. Hey, that's my motto. I've got just the boat for you. Walk this way. This here is the famous Sea Monkey. The only ship ever to make it to Monkey Island. And come back with anyone aboard left alive. Or should I say, anything. You see, the previous owners of this ship were two adventurous pirates. They set off, like many before, to find the legendary secret of Monkey Island, trademarked. One second, please. And like many before, they disappeared forever. Their fate, a mystery. Also as mysterious as how this ship returned to Melee Island without a single human aboard. Some claim it was sailed by a crew of chimps. Chimps? There aren't any chimps in the Caribbean. Oh, shut up. Makes a good story. Anyway, this baby's mine now. That is, until someone makes me an offer. Just how much are you looking to spend today? I have no more than 174 pieces of eight. Look, this is a very reasonably priced ship, but not that reasonable. Doubt you're carrying enough cash on you for this transaction. You wouldn't happen to have any other means of finance, would you? Oh, actually, I was hoping to get one on credit. One second, guys. I'll be there in a minute. Sorry, kid. Neither a borrower nor a lender be. That's just old Stan's philosophy. If you've got a job, then a storekeeper in town might extend you some credit. Okay, so that's what we've got to do. Hello, thank you for asking. I'm doing good. And you? Oh, I forgot to give you my card. And here's something else to remember me by. A compass? An extra strong magnetic compass. With your picture on it? That's right. It always points directly back here, so if you're looking for a good deal, you know where to go. I'll be right here when you come back. But I can't guarantee that any of these ships will. Right. They're moving fast today. Yes, sirree. Can't hardly keep anything in stock. He'll be back. Oh, maybe we can talk to her. Hello, I'm back, and I'm ready to know more about the future. Yikes! So you have returned to learn the future. I see you met some others willing to help in your cause. I really hate that flashing, it makes me see spots. Quiet. I'm getting another vision. You must... Must what? You must go
to Monkey Island. Once there, you will search for the ghost pirate LeChuck. He hides deep, deep beneath Monkey Island trademark. There is only one thing powerful enough to destroy LeChuck.
What?
It's an ancient root. Once prepared, the root can destroy a ghost with one touch.
Yeah?
I'm getting more vision.
Well, spill it.
I see the cannibals that live on the island trademarked.
They are helping you or eating you. I can't tell. The vision isn't coming into clearness anymore.
Oh, great. Now go and find the one that loves you. But be warned.
Don't worry. I'll watch out for LeChuck.
Not of LeChuck, of yourself and what you will find. What you will find about yourself and your world. It will terrify you.
I don't remember how to...
Hey, where'd you go? I hike halfway across the island to try and get your reservation with the Swordmaster, who, by the way, says you can go jump in the lake, and when I come back, you're gone. See if I ever do you a favor again.
Talk to the store.
What do you want?
I'm interested in procuring a note of credit.
Oh, you are you? You got a job?
Yes, of course, I do.
All right. I'll get one of my notes and we'll fill it out.
Okay, now wait, this is important. I missed it. Did you guys see it? It was up. Right, down, right. I'm a grog-swilling, foul-smelling pirate. I'm waiting tables at the scum bar. I'm an acrobat with a traveling circus. I clean ships over at Stan's used shipyard. To be honest, I'm in between jobs. I'm an acrobat with a traveling circus.
You're one of the Fettuccini brothers. Where's your silly accent? And where are your silly slippers? Come back when you've got a job and a credible business.
All right, watch it this time for real, okay? Up, down, right, down, up, right. Wait. Don't save LeChuck, Pete. There's nothing in here but this note. I, the good and honorable storekeeper, do hereby take liability for the debts to the bearer of this note for any amount up to 5,000 pieces of eight. Perfect. Great to see you again. I knew you'd come back. Everybody does. You know why they come back? Wait.
At all these ships, I've got something for everyone. Come, take a look around. So, what else can I show you?
Well, we kind of have the same one. We were pretty close on our voices. I just can't be loud like he can.
What can I show you?
That's the one I'm most interested to try, actually. That's the one I'm most interested to try, is Monkey Island 2. Could I see that cheap one again?
You just can't get her out of your mind, can you? Walk this way. Hard to stay away from a good mystery, isn't it? Let's talk about money. Your money. I got credit from the store keeper. Will you take it? Hey, of course. Your credit's always good at stands. It doesn't matter if you've had credit problems in the past. Divorce, bankruptcy, chronic gambling mishaps. I mean, who am I to judge, right? If the storekeeper trusts you enough to give you a little letter of credit, then you must be an honest man with a steady income, right? Right. Let's get down to brass tacks, shall we? I know you want it. You know you want it. And I know that you know that I want to sell it, so...
That's funny. The guy moves his arms in a crazy way reminds me of a wacky waving inflatable arm tomb man. That was actually pretty hard to read there.
Let's talk extras. Extras? You want to talk extras? Great, this baby's loaded with extras. For instance, did I tell you about the porthole defoggers?
A few moments later.
Alright. 5,000. That's my final offer. Well, it's a little bit more like it, but not much. I know you can try a little bit harder than that. You realize, don't you, that they didn't just make them like this anymore. Yeah, forget it. I don't need this boat anyway. Now, wait a second. Don't go away mad. I'm sure we can work something out.
Sorry, Stan, I'm out of here.
Sure, think it over. I don't want you to feel pressured or anything.
You suck, Stan.
Did I already give you my card? Here. I'd better give you another one just in case.
Thanks.
Shit.
Whoa. Trippy.
5,000 pieces of eight. Okay. It's killing me, but okay. And I thought I was going to buy my children Christmas presents this year. Just take it out of here. I'm glad to get rid of it. Oh yeah, do you have that note from the storekeeper on you?
Now I got it.
Thanks. I've got to run these numbers by my boss, but I think he'll think I'm nuts, but I'm gonna talk him into it. You meet me at the dock with your crew, and I'll bring the ship and the papers. I just want to know what they say when I really feel like we really got to know each other today. I mean, I really felt some bonding here. And I don't just say that to everybody. It's been great doing business with you. Really.
Okay, so yeah, I fucked it up.
Sucker. See you at the dock, and don't forget your crew.
Hold on.
Hey, it's a good thing you showed up. 10 people have offered to buy this baby off me while I've been standing here waiting for you. But I said, no way. I know a guy who's in love with this ship and it would break his heart to lose it. Am I right? Of course I am. I mean, just look at her. Sleek. Aerodynamic. A buoyant, barnacle-covered beauty. I think we're having a real moment here. I've changed my mind. I can't give her up. You can have your money back. How could I sell something so dear? Then again, a deal's a deal, right? Call you later. Good luck. Enjoy. I'm out of here. Oh, whoops. I almost forgot to give you this free seafaring literature. My gift to you. Just remember where you got it. Stands. Maybe I should have gotten all that extended warranty after all.
Hey, long time no see.
Otis, I thought I'd never see you again.
How could I pass up a chance to make some easy money?
Money? Yeah, we are getting paid for this, right? Is it true what I heard about you and the storekeeper?
Look, don't start with me, okay? So, what's that waterlogged wreck doing out there? How are we going to get to our ship?
The center control point is being captured.
Oh shit, what's up, Frame? Framey Frame, bringing in the 19 peoples. It's Victor time!
Oh shit, where's our ship? Wait, hold on. Where's our crew? This isn't going to be as easy as I thought.
Sorry, part two. Frame of travel. About damn time I got to raid you for once. Thank you very much. Give me 1 second to get to a site. Through the courageous leadership of Captain Threepwood, the Sea Monkey is finally underway. Undaunted by their lack of navigational equipment or expertise, the crew begins to plan their voyage.
First of all, I'd like to say it's great to be working with such a fine crew. The voyage ahead is not going to be easy. It's going to take skill, endurance, and most of all, teamwork. First, I thought we'd assign some duties. What is it that we were suckered into doing again? I made a list. Suckered is right. I don't even see what the big deal is with rescuing the governor. She clearly can take care of herself. The way I look at it, we've got this great sheep. Well, we've got a sheep. Why don't we kick back, tie a rope to the wheel, and just cruise for a while? I could use a little work on my tan. Come to think of it, I've also been a little bit stressed out lately. I could use a rest.
Then it's decided. We cruise the Caribbean.
Oh, poor Threepwood. Oh, I'm doomed.
Talk to the mutinous crew.
I hear the weather is pretty nice over by Monkey Island, trademarked.
Nice try, Guybrush, but no banana.
These guys suck.
I'm going to give you mutineers 5 seconds to come to your senses. Then I'm going to start kicking some butt.
Excuse me, Guybrush. Does the word keelhaul mean anything to you?
Keelhaul. I see your point. Thanks. I didn't get to read it because I thought he was going to say it. Is there anything I can do to get you guys to help me?
Excuse me, Guybrush. You're blocking the sun. You're blocking the sun, Master Bruce. Oh, I'm Meuk.
That's the name. So, they're pointless. Alright, we gotta figure out what to do, now. I don't see anything special about it. Maybe we could fire ourselves from the cannon again. Let's go take a look around. There's nothing up here. Where's the hatch? There's hatch. There it is. A lot of fun. I think I'm going to get seasick. Okay, so we can definitely do something in here. Walk to the pot. Looks like your run-of-the-mill ship's cooking pot. Okay. Open the cupboard. I loved this stuff when I was a kid. I like the way it chewed up on the roof of your mouth. That's amazing. What does it look like in the new version? Oh, they changed it. That's Captain Crunch. Ooh, okay. We do need to look at this giant piece of rope. It's a giant piece of rope. Okay.
It looks like an old pirate's chest. There's some very fine wine in here. I'll grab it. Okay. I'm no enologist, but judging from the deep red color, this is a very fine wine.
Boop.
They're just old rusty chests. Ah, they're all rusted shut. They look like kegs of gunpowder. Wow! Gunpowder! I think I'll take some. So we've got gunpowder. It's an old rusty chest. Okay. They rusted shut. Alright. So we've got gunpowder.
Whoop.
Any ideas, gentlemen? I'm gonna call it a night. Enjoy the monkeys, everybody. Well, we've lost our lifeline. That could be bad. It's the top of a cereal box used as a bookmark. Let's use the gunpowder in this box. I don't have a recipe. I wouldn't know where to begin making soup. Okay, we got a box of cereal. I thought I saw a ladder on the mast of the main level. Did you explore that? No, I did not. Let's go take a look. This rope ladder. What a fine looking flag. Shiver me timbers just looking at it. What's up, Mumble Beans? How's it going, buddy? We're trying to make our way through this wonderful game called Monkey Island. There's no place here to put the gunpowder. All right, so use the gunpowder in the cannon nozzle. Okay. Use Jolly Roger with cannon nozzle. This isn't going to work. Hey, what's up, Shayo? I promise nothing. Oh, great. I do want to read this dusty book one more time. So ready? It says, Captain's Log, March 10th. First Mate Toothrot and I have been searching for Monkey Island for over a month with no success. The directions we purchased on Melee proved to be a recipe, not a map, as we had believed. Captain's Log, March 12th. I wish Toothrot would take a bath. Captain's Log, March 17th. I wish Toothrot would stop snoring. Captain's Log, March 23rd. Toothrot is really starting to get on my nerves. I figure it's only a matter of time before we come to blows. Captain's Log, April 2nd. As a gesture to restore our friendship, Toothrot offered me to fix the dinner tonight. Captain's Log, April 3rd. I don't know how we did it, but we arrived at Monkey Island. Both Toothrot and I passed out from the soup he fixed last night. When we awoke, Monkey Island was sitting off the bow. Captain's Log, April 4th. Toothrot and I filled the rowboat with supplies and are ready to set out to Monkey Island, trademarked. We are both excited at the prospect of being the first civilized people to learn the secret of Monkey Island. Captain's Log, April 5th. We had to turn around and return to the ship. Toothrot forgot to go to the bathroom before we left. We'll set out again tomorrow. That's the last entry. All right. So that's what it is. We've got to figure out the recipe. If we can figure out the recipe, it'll knock out everybody on board and it'll send us to the island. So, what's the recipe? Looks like an empty chest. Shit. Look at those bros just chilling. They're not much of a helpful crew, are they? Mumble Beans, it's good, man. We beat... Would it be in the kitchen? It might be good.
That is a good starting place for looking for a recipe. And, you know, I'm sad but happy that I beat Monkey Island, or not Monkey Island, Zelda. But I do miss it a little bit. A little bit. Looks like your run-of-the-mill ship's cooking pot. So let's use cereal with cooking pot. I don't have a recipe. I don't know where to begin making soup. But they did say that the... Wait. Did you guys see a map anywhere? They said that the map that they bought was not a map at all. It was a... There you go. This is like the perfect song for this. It's your stream. No, I know. I'm just trying to get everything worked. I'm very much... Ah, wait. I can't pick that up. Take one for me. What's up, buddy? This is perfect. Yep. Pirates of the Caribbean song would be better. I do not want to risk that again. We just need to find the recipe. If we can find the recipe, I think we've got this in the bag. You opened the cereal already? I don't think I've tried to open the cereal because I think there might be a recipe. Oh, never mind. There it was. Yeah. I tried to do that. I tried. I said like use cereal, not open. Oh, there is no prize. It's a small key with a finely engraved monkey on it. Okay. Everyone cheers for Holly. My buttoned uses were not good enough. I tried to use cereal, not open. I thought using the food would be okay. Well done. Man, that's heavy, filled no doubt with gold and jewels. Hey, look, a piece of paper. And some cinnamon sticks. Directions to Monkey Island. Preheat pot to 450 degrees and add the following ingredients. 1 cinnamon stick, 4 leaves of mint, 1 human skull pressed, 1 squirt of squid ink, 2 pints of monkey blood, 1 live chicken, 3 ounces of brimstone, 1 or more of the following. Preoxidine hydrochloride, zinc oxide yellow 8, mine monatorium and BHA. Let bubble over low flame until thickened, served crew of 4. Okay, so we got to use our big brains here. Watch this. This is where we use our big brains. Holly is a genius and Peter is a doofdum. We always knew I was a doofdum, so it's okay. I see. It's the governor, not the mayor. Thank you, Jan-Monique. So here's the thing. One pressed human skull looks like this, right? A Jolly Roger. That's one pressed human skull. One chicken. I'm gonna use our chicken on a pulley. About time I got rid of this worthless artifact. 4 mints. Breath mints. Good thing I've got a million of these. Now, let's see what else we need to use. 1 cinnamon stick. I love cinnamon. But yeah, it'd be a dream come true. 1 squirt of squid ink. We've got ink. 2 pints of monkey blood. Monkey blood. Yeah, maybe that's fine wine. Yeah,
should be enough. There's the ink. Just a drop. And cereal's full of chemicals. Yikes! Oh, I think I'm getting dizzy. Overcome by the fumes and stench, Guybrush quickly loses consciousness. Moments later, the voodoo spell kicks in, turning the ship into an unknown heading and off on its mysterious voyage. Days pass. I feel awful. It's full of crap. I hope I don't have to eat this. It's full of crap. Holy monkey bladders. It's Monkey Island, trademarked. Wow, that was well worth $59.95 plus tax. Did they even notice? Hey, look! Hey, look! We've made it to Monkey Island! Trademarked.
Let us know when you found the governor. We've got an extra chair she can use.
It's too far to walk, and besides, I can't swim. Guybrush the Mighty Pirate cannot swim. What do you need to light a cannon with? Yeah, I think we need, like, flint. Or gunpowder. And I put gunpowder in the thing. The nozzle. Deja vu! Isn't going to work. Damn, it's hard. I need maybe more gunpowder. Maybe I just gotta jam that gunpowder, son of a bitch, straight full of gunpowder to really make it fly. Bloop. That's my best guess at this point. I'll take some more. Or maybe it didn't save it before. Like maybe the 4 days ago, it didn't work. Like after I already put some in there. More gunpowder is always better. Stuff it. Maybe more. More gunpowder. More. 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 Bloop. I've got enough gunpowder for now. All right, let's get this thing on the road. But I am excited for this Thursday. I'm, you know, to be fully honest, I'm nervous about the collaboration. Do cannons? You do have to light a fuse, right? And I just don't. I don't have a lighter yet. Though I did see a rope. See, that's what I thought. Well, I thought maybe the rope could be used as, like, what? I did that. I used the rope on it, like, 50 times. I did. That pisses me off. Okay, now we just need to figure out how to turn it on light. But now he's got to light it. Yeah, now he's got to figure out how to light it. If I was... Well, maybe I can use more rope. That doesn't seem to work. Maybe I can just use the fuse. With... cinnamon. That doesn't seem to work.
Have you already played Stardew Valley? I love... yes, I did start. There was a fire underneath that. That's a good point. I forgot about that. Thank you. You guys are so much smarter than me, it's embarrassing. Do you think I should use the red hot fire? Perhaps I should use the red hot fire. I may need this later. So how can I... Under Monkey Island. It was the t-shirt. Hi, I'm Herman Toothrot. Don't bother to say hello. I've only been waiting 20 years to talk to somebody civilized. I don't mind. Fine. By the way, you might want to think about putting out that fire. Someone could be hurt. Notice of public meeting. There will be a meeting on Wednesday evening to discuss the recent occupation of the sacred monkey head by the ghost pirate LeChuck. And the subsequent impact on the environment and the tourist trade. All Monkey Island trademarked cannibals are encouraged to attend. Alright, so, let's go find stuff. We are not beating the game tonight. Yes, we are, Treon. First, we're going to go check out this crack. Okay. It's a pair of oars. Ooh. Sturdy stump. Do we have any rope still? We don't. We lost our rope. Let me look at this banana. It's yellow. Okay. Walk to... Can we look at the sturdy stump? It looks sturdy. All right, that's not where we need to go yet. Predictions? I think I can beat it tonight. Why not? Let's try to talk to this monkey. Ooh, shit. Give banana to monkey? Not until he comes down. Ah, we got a monkey friend. All right. I don't know what that does, but we got one. Let's see if we can find another spot. Oh shit, this is huge. Let's go to the dried riverbed and look for some new items to collect. Can we enter the dry riverbed? I guess you can't. I guess you're stuck just looking at it. Boy, sure is hot here. Okay, let's look at the note under the rock. I'll take this interesting rock, too. It's printed on letterhead. To the ghost pirate LeChuck.
We must ask you once again to curtail your nightly activities in the sacred Monkeyhead Arena area. Decent people are trying to sleep. Kindly keep the noise level down. The Monkey Island, TM, Cannibals. P.S. We saw you taking that woman with the scarf down there. To the Monkey Island Cannibals. Please stop moving this. It is delicately balanced. Herman Toothrot. So, I'm pretty sure we're going to have to push a rock and then this will fly off someplace. My son was like, oh yeah, this game is so cool. I'm going to get it for both of us. That's amazing, Zila. You are the best mom ever. Okay, here's what we're going to try. Hey, Pete, this is my first time of your streams I've caught live. Chris led me to you, and I'm glad to have discovered a cool Twitch channel. Thank you very much. Give me 1 second. I never get tired of this view, even if I have been looking at it for over 20 years now, even if it is the only view on the island. Yeah, it is a nice view. I'm afraid I must be going now. Pressing business, you know. Oh, so he's more like the old prospector. Hello, buddy. I don't think I want it. No, I want you to push the rock. Whoops.
Oh no, that was my ship. God damn it.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood. I'm a mighty pirate.
Oh.
That's what we wanted right there. I think. And so here's the one thing I wanted to tell you guys. Let me push this rock off. Push rock. This is going to hit the tree, I think. Hit the tree. Wow! Looked like it hit the big banana tree on the beach. I bet the odds against that are incredible. Is this your main thing or a side gig? I saw you in abroad in Japan and you went to Wakanai. This is all just a side gig. My main job is I teach at a private school from, what is that? From 7 a.m. until 4:30 p.m. Come home, sleep for 2 hours, jump on the stream. All right, I'm stuck. Where do we go? Okay, wait. Team Stream Saturdays will be epic. Yes, they will. Can I go all the way up here somehow? No, I can't. Okay, we gotta figure out how to get around this giant thing. Take a swim, maybe? Oh, shit! We got a clearing. We have a beach. Let's look at this bottle. There's a message in it. It's a memo. To Herman Toothrot. From Yammer, him and Haw, attorneys at law. Regarding suit against cannibal tribe over malicious tossing of your oars into a chasm. I think we have a case here. We can probably soak them for emotional distress and possibly punitive damages as well. Sounds like legalese. I don't think I can translate the rest.
Hey, did you come in that ship that I saw out there? You're braver than you look. Actually, it looks a lot like a ship I used to own.
What do you mean, braver than I look?
Never mind.
Are you some kind of a castaway?
What do I look like, the caretaker? Listen to this guy. Am I some kind of a castaway?
The old man wearing the hot pants, the saucy devil. I think he does, he's been I thought this island was uninhabited. Thank you very much, man.
Well, you thought wrong. My name's Toothrot, Herman Toothrot. I live here. Well, not right here. In the fort, now on the volcano.
Were you stranded?
You think I stay here for my health? Oh, boy.
Private property. Worshipping is permitted, but please do not enter the monkey head. G.P. LeChuck.
Look at the skulls. Yipes! Shish kebab.
I want to see how Dominic Armato said that.
Shish kebab.
Shish kebab.
Shish kajo.
Shish kajo. That's funny. Shish kaleri.
That's a good joke. That's funny, guys.
Shish kebab, shish kaleri. Is that the new Pog champ? I love that, by the way. The Ryu champ. Shish kajo. Eep. Let's look at the totem pole. The artist carved their name on it. Made by Red Skull. Made by Sharptooth.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that monkey had some piece of work, eh? That's the case of yellow waxy buildup, though.
How did you get stranded here?
Well, I sailed here with a friend of mine 20 years ago. We hoped to discover the secret of Monkey Island, trademarked, but my friend met with a horrifying and tragic accident, which claimed his life, and I couldn't sail the ship back myself. I trained a bunch of chimps to crew the ship and sail back to Melee Island, trademarked. They were supposed to get help and come back for me. Something must have happened.
How come you didn't just go with the chimps?
Well, weeks on a boat full of monkeys? Oh, joy.
I'm Guybrush. I'm here to rescue someone.
Well, here I am. Glad you came to rescue me. Though I thought you might have been a bit earlier. That find on that overdue library book should be pretty big by now. Let's go.
That's not exactly what I meant. I sailed here in pursuit of the governor of Melee Island, who's been kidnapped by a ghost.
Okay, fine, don't rescue me. I like it here. The rain on my head, the wind at my back, the bugs on my plate.
Perhaps I could take you back too, but I've got to rescue the governor's first. I think she's on that ghost ship underground.
Oh, okay.
What happened to your pants?
What pants?
You say you got a key from the locals?
Yeah, I lent my banana picker to them and they never gave it back. As collateral, they gave me this enormous cotton swab. It opens the monkey head, see? Well, not like I ever need to go into the monkey head. But if they run it back, I've got to give my picker first. It's a matter of pride, you know?
Why don't you just give me the key to the monkey head?
Well, no, I need it to get back my banana picker.
So you're not the only one on the island?
I'm the only civilized person on this here island. There's a native tribe of hunter-gatherers. Well, they're head hunter-gatherers, actually. But I don't talk to them. They are cannibals, but they're not dangerous. Unless you lend them something. I told you about them borrowing my banana picker and I never returning it, right?
Excuse me, I've got pressing business to attend to.
Yeah, me too.
Ooh, there's a pond, wait. Oh shit, this guy's dead. To the Monkey Island cannibals. I don't mind you worshipping in front of the sacred Monkey Isle, which doubles as my home and secret base of operations. But could you please refrain from leaving messy sacrifices on my porch? Also, please do not enter the monkey head. G.P. LeChuck. Holy water may survive.
Well, this is an old friend of mine, the only one I sailed here with. He's lost weight. Never looked better.
Wow, he looks pretty bad.
Well, you never saw him when he was still alive.
Let's try to give him this this banana. Give you the banana. Come here, monkey. 171. Don't tell me those things. I get nervous. This is your third damn banana. Do something.
Well, how do I, what the fuck do I do? Where the fuck?
This poor bean seems to have been rather befuddled right now, doesn't he? Dare say he does, old man. Oh, he's not keen. Oh, bollocks. It'll take him nothing more than a moment to find that volcano. You know what we need? I know just the thing to help.
There we go, baby. Fuck yeah! Okay, now we're talking. Back to the game. What did I come back to? We finally made some progress. Just the right amount of volcano. All right, let's look at the rope. Good, strong stuff. Shit. Ooh, look, there's a spyglass. Warning. Objects in the spyglass may be farther away than they appear. Now, I can't pick that up. I want to push it.
Hey. Oh, nice little spyglass. Looks just like... Hey, where is my spyglass? Oh, perfect. I'm gone 5 minutes. Somebody comes in here, dumps gunpowder all over the floor. Naturally, I don't think you had anything to do with it. I'm sure it was just a coincidence that you came in here on the prowl right after my mysterious person dirtied up my nice clean floor.
I saw a monkey leaving here. He must have done it.
Oh, you don't fool me, sonny.
Excuse me. I've got pressing business to attend to.
Yeah, me too.
Is that everything? Let me see. Okay. We got some new stuff. I've got enough. Nah, nothing to look at here. Okay, so let's take a look. The rope, I think, can help us get the... I've got it. I have an idea. Maybe. Let's blow up the dam. Yoshino, boom!
Narrator, he didn't got it. Flint works best with things made of steel.
Ah! Oh, man! That wasn't bad. We did something. That was incredibly short-sighted, though, and stupid.
Well, I have one more idea first. I know we can get the, grave robbing. Hooray! No, the dried out... Where's the empty place? You guys know what I'm talking about? It was like the gorge. You know, the emptied out gorge with the thing. Move the corpse somehow. Good idea. Okay, was it the crack? Yeah, where's the crack? Yes, yes. Thank you. The crack's way down here. Thank you, space. Let me use rope. Good. Strong stuff. I can't reach that from here. Okay. Pete looking for crack in the jungle. What else is new? I knew he was on crack. It's from similar games I like, the Ponia series, where it's comedy. Oh, yeah. That's a use rope with tree. There's ropes not long enough to reach the canyon floor from a tree. I'll try it with that branch. Psht. What? There was a branch? Okay, we made it a little bit further. We need more rope. I think we need the rope from the dead man. I didn't see that, guys. I didn't see the other small rope next to him, okay? All right, now we're going to use rope on sturdy stump. Boom! We did it, big brainers. Is that what you're saying? Oh, I can paddle with these oars. That's right, baby. Now we've got ourselves a boat. Okay, cannibals. I'm not giving you bloodsuckers your key to the monkey head until you return my banana picker. HT. The plot thickens. The ground quakes. Finally, we can go to the village. Ooh! It's an empty hut. I can't see inside from here, but I'll bet it's empty. I just opened your channel and the first thing I saw was cannibals. This should be interesting. This hut is very empty. This is a great, great game, Zero Skill. It's one of my favorites. Boy, this is the emptiest hut I've ever seen. Where is everybody? No two ways about it. This hut's empty. Everybody's been eaten. Oh, man. You're right. Looks a little overripe, except for those nice, juicy bananas. This door appears to be locked. Well, let's try picking up the juicy bananas.
You know, juicy bananas are delicious, right?
Feed the statue. Ah, yes. I don't want to get any closer to that thing. It might be booby-trapped. Oh, shit, wait.
Is that a banana in your pocket? Are you just glad to see us? You've got a lot of nerve stealing from the notorious Monkey Island trademark cannibals.
You're cannibals?
Well, yes. Although lately we've been trying to stay away from red meat. Only for health reasons. We're still as vicious as ever, especially with tourists who try to steal our stuff for souvenirs. Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
Don't eat me! I'm a mighty pirate!
That means his skin will be leathery and his meat tough and stringy. You are of no use to us, nutritionally speaking, but if you had some sort of offering for us, something that we could pass on to the great monkey, well...
Obviously, you have nothing for us. We might eat you.
We might let you go. We'll have to talk about it with the village nutritionist. Come, let me show you to our guest hat. That should do it.
It says, if found, please return to Herman Toothron. Oh, we got the banana picker. To the ghost pirate LeChuck, we must protest your acquisition of our voodoo anti-root. We realize that it presents a hazard to you and your crew, but this is thievery. The Monkey Island trademarked cannibals. I think that's how I'll end up if I don't get out of here soon. Ah, no thanks. They still got some meat on them. So these cannibals are vegetarians because... I don't think hanging myself is the answer. How does he say that in...
I don't think hanging myself is the answer.
Not bad. Yeah, it doesn't open. Oh, I got a skull. What a nice, cute little skull. I might fit through that hole, but I don't think this banana picker will. Damn it!
And no, I'm not getting squeamish. I'd love to eat the guy. So let's do it. But think of your arteries. We are cannibals, for crying out loud. Yes, but cannibals have to watch their saturated fats just like everyone else.
Okay. Okay. Interesting. Couldn't you have just given them a banana? I don't think any of those work, because I stole the banana from them. It was a cute little child skull. No, that was a fully grown adult skull. Maybe there's something on this side of the mountains that we can look at. And there's not. Shit.
Oh, like good morning, Peter Senpai, keeping the stream nice and tasty, like a good ocean wave. Funny you should mention that, Red Eye Jedi. Tonight, I had one of my very first collaborations with Mudon TV, and we played an old game called Battleship.
It was really fun. You remember Battleship when you were like a kid, like B-12 and A-5?
Hold on 1 second. I want to take a look at the... Okay, wait.
Okay. Bash the bananas into the smoothie for cannibals on a health kick? I genuinely have no idea.
Oh, Battleship, like the amount of fights my brother and I got over into that game.
It's really fun on stream, and I think it was exciting and heart-racing at the same time. Hold on 1 second.
The banana thief returns to the scene of the crime. Maybe we should just eat him right now. Do you have any idea how much cholesterol is in one of these things? Now then, did you break out of our hut and why did you come back?
Look behind you, a three-headed monkey.
Hey, do you really think we're that stupid? I wouldn't push it if I were you.
Now, go ahead and eat. See if I care.
Not the three-headed monkey!
There it was! Still holds up. Door appears to be locked.
It's real!
And they didn't fall for it. That's what I think, this 3-month sub, if we could somehow... Let me go see if I can... Nathan did say he worked on a prototype of the three-headed monkey for the sub badge. Let's go take a look. All right, guys. Use your big heads. How can we possibly get past this puzzle? What are we missing? We have the oars. We need the banana picker to give to Truthrot.
Do you really think we're that stupid?
Oh, I'm so dumb.
It's not unusual to be stumped by this game.
What's up, Pete? Loving the chill stream. Thank you, Johnny. I wish I was a little bit better at figuring this out. I can't remember. Use cannonball with window? It doesn't seem to work. Ooh. Talk to skull? That doesn't seem to work.
Okay.
Push the cannonball into the window? So the problem, Clive, is that when we go to the window or to escape this dungeon, Guybrush can't fit the banana picker into the escape hatch. He can't fit the thing right into the escape hatch, so he puts it back. So my guess is, we got 2 new bananas. Maybe if you keep escaping, they'll just give up. I mean, that's actually not a bad idea. What's up? Let's go to the beach. More black powder? Can you break the door from the front? These are good questions. Okay, wait. So far, I've given that one monkey 3 bananas. Should I just try giving him the final 2?
Okay, give banana to monkey. Eat. That's 5. Oh, fuck. He's following me. Okay. Let's see what it says. Ready? Pull the nose to show the monkey how to open the gate. I didn't even know there was a nose. Oh, man. I did try to do that. Guys, remember I tried to use the totem poles. I didn't see the extra nose. I knew it was the totem pole. I tried. I tried the totem. But I don't know if this... What a cheap piece of mass-produced tourist crap. On the bottom it says, made by Lemonhead. Oh, but see, this is something that they can give to the monkey. Because it's an idol, and they'll say like, okay, thanks, we'll go give this as an offering to the great monkey. Something spiritual. That's the idol, for sure. Way to go, us. I have to pee again. Oops, wrong button. What's up, hand girl? P.O. Box win so I can make an offering to our great monkey. I walked away. Well, I'm happy that you're back. Too much coffee. That is true. Plus, I can't believe it's already... I'm stunned. We've been sitting here walking around this island for an hour. This game is so much fun. I love this game. It's just such a tremendous adventure. Like, this reminds me of being a kid and what games used to mean to me. Go faster, you little bitch. Also, I would like you to go ahead and vote on what game we're playing next. There are 5 choices. Please go take a look. And can we remove the Nightbot poll parameter? Is there a way to remove that function? Premier ship poop shit. No, no, no. What now? I'll give you anything. Okay, we'll give you one more chance to trade something of yours for your freedom. Hey, wow, this is impressive. Lemonhead, take a look at this. And it says made by Lemonhead, just like one of mine. We should take this to the great monkey. Yes, I agree. We are very grateful for you for this fine gift. If there's ever anything you need on Monkey Island, just come see us. Give banana picker to Herman Toothrot.
Hey, thanks. I thought I'd never see this again. Here, you can take this key to the monkey head back to the natives.
Okay. And don't worry, I won't use it or anything. Damn, Guybrush has amazing stamina rowing that boat all across the island. Sure does. You should see the stamina of the guy playing as Guybrush. Yeah. You know what? I've decided that... Shut up. No, listen to me. It's true. I have decided that when we play games from now on,
less tangents, or if I have the tangent, it'll be during the gameplay. I'm gonna be committed. You heard it right here, committed to beating these games faster. We're gonna use the monkey head and the gigantic monkey ear. Ugh. What is the context behind this emote? I don't even know if I remember. But I like it. Ah, right, it's the ADT security. Oh, sweet, we go down like his monkey abs and stuff. Oh shit, there's more, look at the eyes. Hellish. Is this random every time? Use monkey head key and big nose. Nah, I'd rather not touch it. I can't reach it. So I think this one is pretty tough. I think we need some sort of a guide. Yes. Okay, we made it out. All right, let's talk to these guys. Hold on a minute.
Have you come back to let us repay you for your fine gift?
Well, actually, there is something.
Tell us, what is it?
I'm looking for somebody.
Here? On Monkey Island, trademarked. We're the only people living on Monkey Island, trademarked. Well, the only civilized people.
That's okay. The people I'm looking for aren't living.
Oh, yeah. Those guys. Then you've seen the ghost pirate LeChuck and his cadaverous crew. Those jerks have been bugging us for months. Zooming around here in that creepy ghost ship of theirs. Wailing and moaning until all hours of the morning. Scaring away all the cruise ship businesses. Normally, when we have problems with the undead, we just cook up our standard portion of exorcism and be done with it.
So, why don't you do that now?
Well, the main ingredient of the potion is a very rare root. In fact, there's only one in existence. We only use a little bit at a time, you see. But LeChuck stole the whole thing.
LeChuck came in here and stole your root? What a cad.
Oh, and I suppose stealing bananas is any better?
Where is he hiding it?
He's in a place beneath this island, somewhere on a huge systems of catacombs. A hellish place filled with the wailing of the tortured souls trapped forever in the rock. Where the walls bleed and the air is thick with the rancid smell of pure evil. Tourists used to line up for hours to see it.
What happened? The health department shut you down?
No, we lost the key. It was stolen. Well, we loaned it to a hermit who lives on the island. And until that crusty old pantless weirdo brings things back, we're keeping his banana picker.
I'm off to find LeChuck and get the root.
Sorry, it's just not that easy. Trying to find LeChuck could be very dangerous. You'd never find your way through the catacombs without the... Hey! Ixnay on the Idne of the Abigatorine.
The what?
Nothing.
What is the Idne of the Abigatorine?
I see. He is baffled by our native dialect. Good. We could at least tell him what the head does. Well, it's a navigating tool. It's a head. It was once attached to a navigator. We've kept it alive magically so we could take advantage of its innate sense of direction. Getting through the catacombs without it is impossible. But it's our only one, so you cannot have it. I guess we have nothing to offer you. And after he gave us the nice idol too, feel free to come to the Great Monkey and visit your idol at any time. So anyway, Lemonhead, what was that you were saying about the tropical oils?
Bill?
Okay.
Excuse me, but we're in the middle of a serious discussion. I know, but I really need that navigator head thing. I told you, we only have one. We don't know how to get another one. Buddy!
So, this is a really interesting puzzle.
私の記憶が確かなれば.
This was very hard when I grew up. Probably the hardest thing I can remember on this game. I'll try to give compass to friendly natives.
Ah, one of those newfangled magnetic compass hills. Do high tech. Yeah, give me a good old-fashioned disembodied head any day.
Crack the skull, eat the compass, and smack them with the book. Not quite. I'm just going to tell you what I remember, at least. Are you ready? If my memory serves me correctly, because this was so hard when I grew up, and I was talking to Ian about this last night. It's this. It's called How to Get a Head in Navigating. It's called How to Get a Head in Navigating.
Pretty good memory for an old man. Colonel, I can't believe that this guy has a memory of like he's 37. Snake, sometimes when gamers play hard games, it gets so locked into their brain that they can't forget it. Colonel, is that kind of like how, you know, when I tried to find and contact Meryl, I had to remember to use the looking on the back of the PlayStation disc? Snake, that's exactly what I mean. Using your head in intense combat situations can mean the difference between life and death. Colonel, thanks. I think I'll just try to give them the leaflet.
Well, look at this. It looks like instructions on how to get a head. We could give him our head and use these instructions to get ourselves a new one. Yes, I suppose we can give you this now.
Thanks.
Looks pretty good for a dried up old head, doesn't it? We keep it wrapped in this magical necklace that makes it invisible to ghosts.
Oh.
Look!
He likes you.
He likes you.
Just follow his nose and he'll lead you to LeChuck.
Just follow his nose and he'll lead you to LeChuck's hideout. Then get the route from LeChuck and come back here. Talk about the name. And we'll make a mix-up batch of our special enzymatic ghost-dissolving solution. And you can pour it on LeChuck like a salt in a slag.
Yeah.
Good luck.
I think he wants me to go to the left.
Okay.
Oh, God. This took me the wrong way. Okay.
It's that eerie-looking ghost ship I saw sailing off with the governor!
It's you guys!
You wouldn't happen to have a route I could borrow. I've come to interrogate the prisoner. Excuse me, but is this the Lido deck?
I wonder which one I want to do.
I've come to interrogate the prisoner.
Yikes!
Libido deck? Yikes! Uh-oh. What have we done? Oh! This necklace. It's slimy and goopy.
You can't have it. It's mine.
But we've got to use that thing because it makes you invisible to ghosts. Can we just throw the navigator away now?
Okay, we're here. Now what do you want from me?
Hello, head.
Hello.
Thank you for leading me to the ghost ship.
Hey man, no problem, mate. When you only have one job, you do it well, you know what I mean?
May I please have that necklace?
No, but thanks for asking so politely.
Maybe I'll just take it?
Maybe you'd better not.
Aye. Pretty please?
You can beg all you want, matey, but you can't have it.
I don't want to have to hurt you.
And I don't want to have to make you regret it.
What are you gonna do? Fight me?
Remember, you need me to get out of this place. If you wanted, I could just strand you in here forever.
Yeah, but if I wanted, I could dropkick you into the lava.
On second thought. Hey, what's a good necklace if you don't have shoulders?
This feels weird. Well, that worked.
That was Elvis Presley.
Oh, look, there's a ghost dog. Hey, what a cute little ghost dog. Looks like Monkey Island, trademarked. It's got little wiggling blue hairs in it. It looks like that creepy guy I saw on the upper deck.
Who dares enter the cabin of the ghost pirate LeChark? Strange places, strange noises. The wind makes not such a creaking. The ship sounds strange in these waters.
Okay. Gotta figure that one out. Oh damn, there's like a passed out. That guy's awesome. What was that? LeChuck is a ghost. Yes, he is. He looks sound asleep. Damn. Oh. Wait.
see that? There was like a bottle.
Zoinks, Scoobs!
I can't get it away from him. Okay. Let's go look at the ghost chickens. I don't see anything special about it. I can't get inside of it. It's nailed, chained, bolted, roped, glued, and welded together. Well... open hatch. It's locked tight. Must be something really important down there. Maybe we need the... what do we need? Here you go, Pete. No! Oh, God! Amazing. This is art. That's perfect. That's so... unsettling. Oh, that's so stupid. That's my sleep paralysis demon right here. All I got was a feather. Maybe we use the feather on his feet? It's a bottle of ghost grog. Big brain Pete at it again. Let me go ahead and give myself the props. Here we go! So wait, use compass with key. I want to look at the key. I want to read about it. It's a big, ghostly looking key. The key doesn't seem to fit. Grease! It's covered with rat slobber. It looks drunk. That's the biggest goat rat I've ever seen. I'm not gonna go near that monster rat. I don't see anything special about it. Yikes! I hate rats. Oh, God. Use jug of grog with rats? No, I think I'd rather save it. Use jug of grog with dish? Okay, that worked. It's a vat of cooking grease. Yuck, it's all over my hands. Give the creepy Pete head the booze. Wow, that rat is on crack. Oh, it died. Now we can grease the door, exactly. Let's do that really quick. Use glob of grease on squeaky door. This should stop it from squeaking. Look at these ghost tools. They're glowing ghost tools. Oh, good. More inventory. Use ghost tools with glowing crate. This should do it.
Now I'll just grab this old root and be on my way. It's twisted and dried up and not very impressive looking. Okay, so we have the root. So now I think we can leave, right? A long walk, a brief row, and a short hike later. Well, that was nice of them. I did it! I got the root! Wow. Look, he's not kidding. Here it is. It's not such a wimp after all. Come on, let's go make the brew of the fermented root. Wait here. Yeah, we'll be right back. Nice, monkey. I got the root. I'm not such a wimp after all. I'd love to have you stuffed. I'd make a fortune. Which one? I'm gonna tell him I'm not a wimp. I'll tell him I got the root. I got the root. There it is. One squirt of that stuff and the ectoplasm really hits the fan. And if you have any left over, it's delicious with a little vanilla ice cream. Good luck. Thanks. We got root beer. It seems to be filled with some carbonated fluid. After some more furious paddling. Ah! You scared me half to death. Balmy weather we're having today, isn't it? Well, it's always like this down here. What happened to the ship? Well, they all left for the wedding. What wedding? LeChuck is marrying the governor of Mele Island. What? But how will they... And why are you still here? My head fell into the lava there, and I had to chase after it. And when I came back, they all had gone. Shame, too. I hate to miss the wedding. Where is the wedding? There's a lovely church on Mele Island. They're headed there. Mele Island? Oh, no! I've got to go after them! I've got to stop that wedding! Bye. Bob! What are you doing here? Oh, I missed the boat to the wedding. Hey, no problem. We can take mine. Let's go. Hey. You have a ship? Yeah. If you have a ship, then why are you waiting to be rescued?
Well, why heck, if you're so stranded, you've got to be rescued. Says so in the rules.
How did you get in here without a head?
Well, I have a head.
That's a funny joke.
Will you take me to Mele Island?
Well, I'll lend you my ship if you promise to rescue me with it.
Okay.
Let's go.
Last part. Guybrush kicks butt. Last part. Well, that was certainly easier than the trip to Monkey Island. I wonder where Toothrot's gone to now. Now I'll have to stop the wedding by myself. Yikes!
Hey. Wait a second.
Ooh, I've got four cool ones. Swill this, you creepy crawly!
foul-smelling grog to swill. Swell! Oh, ho, ho. Do you have an invitation to the wedding?
Do you have an invitation to a wedding?
Why, yes, I do. No, I'm a gatecrasher. No, but I do have this deadly magic root beer. I must have left it in my other pants. Bye now.
Not so fast, buddy. You don't look very ghost-like to me. You're very pink.
It's a sunburn. I suffer from a rare pigmentation efficiency syndrome. Try not to take this root beer too personally. I suffer from a rare pigmentation efficiency syndrome.
Oh, I don't sound much like a ghost either. Could you whirl and moan and roll around with some chains or something?
My chains are at the cleaners. They're being degreased.
Oh! So, you sound a lot like my dog.
It's busy being overpowered by your own deathly stench. Oh, that! Just let me get my boots off. It's a new root beer cologne. Perhaps you'd like to try it. Oh, let me just get my boots off.
Oh, no, no, never mind. If you're really a ghost, prove it. Let's see you just pop your head off.
Forget it. This stuff's great. Watch out, LeChuck. There's a new sheriff in town, and his name? Hey, I'd better get to the church. That's not the church.
If there be any man with reason that these two, people should not be united in blissful matrimony, let him speak now or forever hold his peace.
There goes the guy, shut up.
The groom isn't a gentleman. The groom isn't a human. Elaine.
Oh, hi.
Hey, who's that? You. I've come to stop you from marrying Governor Marley. Please don't kill me. Take this, you vaporous voodoo vermin. I've come to stop you. How do you plan to do that? Governor. Governor.
Governor.
What's going on here? Oh, Guybrush, you mad fool. I'm impressed you actually came to rescue me, but it really wasn't necessary. I had everything well in hand. Unfortunately, your arrival has made it necessary for me to tip my hand early.
How?
Well, I thought LeChuck was going to marry you.
Yes, so did I.
Yes, so did he. But I arranged for a little surprise when it came time to kiss the bride.
Well, if you're in here, then who's in that dress?
What? Don't scare them. They have ghosts zapping a root beer bottle. Oh, I'll get it. Oops. Nice going, Guybrush. Now I've got to chase them down to get my voodoo root beer back. Wait, but... Hey!
You dared to come here and confront me. I can't believe your audacity.
Well, I can't believe your stupidity. I had to stop you from marrying Governor Marley. Well, I can't believe your stupidity.
Yeah. Well, I can't believe your frivolity.
Well, I can't believe your virility.
That's such a Guybrush thing to say.
I can't believe your virility.
Yeah. Well, I can't believe your mobility.
Well, I can't believe your enormity.
Well, yeah. I can't believe your fragility.
No, I can't believe your alacrity.
Alas, I'm grow tired of you. They are...
Say now, let's not be too hasty.
La clapped.
Biff.
Hey, good to see you, son. How's the show? If you're interested in trading up, I can give you a fair price for it. Howdy, partner. You know, just by looking at you, I can tell you're a real man of the world. I have a man for an eye with a quality, and a man who knows a good bargain when he... Ew.
Ow!
Instant replay.
Nice shot.
Blimp cam.
Guybrush scores a first place knockout.
Don't sneak up on me like that.
Nice shot.
Sorry. That's okay. You know, LeChuck was a deviant, obnoxious, slithery, creepy, crummy
nice
sort of guy.
Shot.
But I'll say one thing for him. What's that? He sure looks nice exploding across the night sky. Yes, it's very romantic. Can I buy you a root beer?
Nice shot!
Sure. There's more at Stan's. Gosh, you know, I hope Stan's okay. I wish my crew could have seen this.
You know, I can't shake the feeling that Guybrush was somehow responsible for that big rock sinking the ship.
Yeah. As soon as we find a way off this island, we're gonna have ourselves a little chat with Mr. Threepwood.
Let's get out of this hut first.
Nice shot!
At least I learned something from all of this. What's that? How to deal with frustration, disappointment, and irritating cynicism. It's not the size of the ship. Never pay more than 20 bucks for a computer game.
I think we go with option one.
Or two. What do you guys think? Two? One, two, or three? I think they're all three cool. One, two, three. Great job, everybody. Now, last time I beat it, I did three, so I don't want to do three again. The size of the ship is very Guybrush. Let's try this one. I've never done two yet. I'm going to do two. Sorry. It's not the size of the ship. Yeah, I've heard that one.
We did it, guys!
I feel like I came back in time from history being made. Your voice acting really brought it to life. I don't know, that means so much to me. I think for me,
this game has always been my favorite. Guybrush Threepwood is honestly probably my favorite character in video gaming history. I really like him. What a nice stream of Premier 2, trademarked.